I think what the lesson is to me, like, very rarely does it work out that you take a quarterback who just gives you the right feeling, and it's a good enough reason to take him. Like, Eli Manning got selected one overall because of the name. Otherwise, he's a top pick, but he may not go one overall. But Eli delivered in two Super Bowls. Normally, that's not the way it works. Normally, if you reach for a guy like Mark Sanchez because he gives you a good feeling, that's a mistake. He needs to be big enough, strong enough, fast enough, have a good enough arm, put up the numbers in college, be accurate enough. Like, in other words, Baker,
you can't argue,
he had the numbers because he was playing in that Lincoln Riley offense.
Max, you can't argue with the Jets taking Mark Sanchez because they didn't take Mark Sanchez for him to throw the ball 50 times a game. What they took Mark Sanchez for is exactly what Tannehill is doing in Tennessee. The problem is Mark Sanchez, when they allowed him to throw the football, he turned it over. And so in New York, he became somewhat the joke. But you can't argue with his first several years as a quarterback that he quarterbacked his team to the AFC Championship game, even though most people will say, well, that was the defense. That was the defense. Yes, that was the defense, but he didn't screw it up.
Yeah, but Keith, my point is this:
later on,
you can, if you need a game manager, it's not a dirty word, but if you need a game manager, probably not with the fifth overall pick. You could find that without shooting the fifth overall pick on it.
But he was supposed to be able to deliver when they need him to deliver, not just a game manager.
Mm-hmm.
He was, you know, when.
Yep. Yeah. There's a difference. A game manager. A game manager who's big on third down. Like Tom Brady, Russell Wilson, early in their careers, those were game managers with great defenses who were big on third down, who developed into great quarterbacks.
Absolutely.
Not, you don't have to develop into a great quarterback, but you need to be able to be big on third down and otherwise limit the mistakes. What do you think of, look, the guy, I was surprised that Baker went one overall, though at the time I thought it was the right pick, because Sam Darnold checked more boxes. Usually GMs are risk averse and they're like, I don't want to take Baker because he's short, and then if it doesn't work out, they're going to second guess me. So they take Darnold because Darnold didn't have any boxes unchecked. He's mobile, he has an arm, he has leadership qualities, he's tall, you know, like he drank the Kool-Aid in terms of the football talk. Like, he doesn't have to stop to think about his answer to give you a PC answer. He believes in it and just it comes right out of him. Check, 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 check. What do you think about Sam Darnold right now? A lot of people talking about the Jets probably going to have the worst record in football drafting Trevor Lawrence. Where are you on that?
I don't really like them drafting Trevor Lawrence, and it's not because I don't like Trevor Lawrence. It's because I think they got a quarterback already. They need a new head coach to service so that their quarterback can be serviced and service the Jets and the fan base the right way. A lot of people think they need a quarterback. I don't believe that. I think they need a new head coach and players around them. I'd take that first overall pick, and I'd shop that thing for several number ones and twos and players to be named later. You name it, that's what I would do. I would Dallas Cowboy Herschel Walker that number one overall pick.
But now, wait a minute, Key. You may be right about that. How much of this, Keyshawn Johnson, is SC? You guys at SC, you take care of each other. If it's Mark Sanchez, if it's Sam Darnold, Keyshawn Johnson, boy, you take care of your guys. How much of it is that, Key?
Zero. It has zero to do with it. Do you watch football? Do you see what they got? They don't have anything. You expect for this guy to play under a defensive-minded head coach and do well, that in Todd Bowles, which was a disaster. Jeremy Bates was his offensive coordinator. You know where Jeremy Bates were prior to him being the OC in New York? Do you know where he was at?
Where?
He was in the mountains. Like, literally in the mountains living, like in Wyoming or Montana or something like that. Like, just chilling in a cabin for, like, several years. He was out
getting
of football.
Good,
then you bring
good
him, as,
mountain
a,
air,
then
making
you bring
a good...
him as your offensive coordinator. Yeah. Then they get rid of Todd Bowles. And then you hire Adam Gase, who got fired in Miami, who ruined Tannehill's career. And Tannehill goes to Vrabel and gets $89 million a year later. Like, seriously.
All right, Key, I'm actually, here's the thing. I wouldn't give up on Sam Darnold. I think Sam Darnold has a chance to be good.
Not you. I'm talking about the Jets. They just said Sam Darnold was a life changer at quarterback. You selected him 3 years ago as the number three overall pick and put nothing around him.
But this is what I'm asking, Key. The reason people would say move on is not because I wouldn't. Okay, let me put it this way. I wouldn't say you move on from Sam Darnold because he's no good. I'm not saying that. I agree with the points you're making. What I'm saying is this, and I'm asking you, when you look at Trevor Lawrence, do you see a different kind of talent where the kind of talent where it's like whatever our game plan was or our plan was, we need to take this guy because he's just different. Is Trevor Lawrence that kind of player or not?
Not in my opinion, no, not for me to do it. I'm sorry, not for me to do it. I'd rather move my number one pick and build my team because Trevor Lawrence is not going to solve all the problems we have. I mentioned this earlier, and I'll mention again. If you have any knowledge about football and the Indianapolis Colts when they drafted and selected Peyton Manning, Peyton Manning had Marvin Harrison already there. Trevor Lawrence, if you draft him, he ain't got nobody to throw to in the Jets. They also had a guy named Marshall Faulk before they got Edgerrin James. Do you see any Marshall Faulks or Edgerrin James in that backfield? They also had.
I don't see any Marshall Faulks in the backfield.
They had Terry Glenn on the offensive line.
Okay. Actually, Key, I think Marshall Faulk might be on the Jets right now. I have to look at that.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.